What's up, YouTube? It's your boy, Ricky Rick, and your boy, Ricky Rick, is back. Not with a Ricky Talk, though. This time, I'm doing a Ricky at the Half. Now, I want to talk to you guys about the NBA Finals, which is going down tonight, Game 6. That is, the Toronto Raptors are up 3-2 against the world champions, the Warriors. Now, for anybody who didn't see Game 5, shame on you. Shame on you. Let me tell you what happened. In the second quarter, something major happened to a major player. A player that a lot of people like, a lot of people respect. A guy who's been through a tough journey in these NBA Finals this year. For those that know, for those who follow sports, for those that don't know, I'm talking about Kevin Durant. Kevin Durant is an amazing ball player. He started his career with the Seattle Sonics in the NBA. Then they got moved over to Oklahoma City, became part of this new team called the Thunder, which had James Harden, Russell Westbrook, and Kevin Durant. They were such a solid team for many years. They just couldn't get to the finals. They couldn't get to the championship round and win one. So what did Kevin Durant do a couple years ago? He jumped to another team. He was a free agent and took the opportunity to join a team. You know what they say, if you can't beat them, join them. You know, usually it's not the way like that. But that's what happened. If you can't beat them, join them. And that's what Kevin Durant did. He joined the Warriors. He joined a championship team. He joined a young, talented core team. And who wouldn't jump at the guns to win a championship? There's been a lot of great players in the NBA, like Karl Malone. I was going to say Gary Payton, but I think he won one in Miami. Vince Carter, Charles Barkley. There's a list. The list goes on and on. How many great players came to the NBA? Allen Iverson, Reggie Miller, Chris Webber, who were such great ball players but never won a ring. So Kevin Durant, on the other hand, he joined the Warriors. Not only did he join the Warriors, but made the team better. Helped the team win a couple more championships, saving the team by doing what he does best, playing b-ball. And he won NBA MVP, Finals MVP, twice in a row. You know, right now, the Warriors are in a little bit of a pickle. They're down, like I said, they were down 3-1. Game 5, hold up, let me come back here. There's so much to say that some things I want to talk about. It's just like, so when they played Game 1, I believe Kevin Durant got injured. So he wasn't able to play in Game 2, wasn't able to play in Game 3, wasn't able to play in Game 4. Finally, he comes back in Game 5, what could have been an elimination game for the Warriors. But Kevin Durant came, got a good jump, got a good start, got a good feel of the game. He got cleared 24 hours before Game 5 to play. He played, ended up going down in the second round, second quarter, and it just sucks. It sucks to see that happen to a player that loves this game, you know. Let me show you guys. Let me see if I can go back here. I'm on my Facebook right now. I posted something because, you know, it really does, you know, I can relate. I used to love this game so much. I have a passion for the game. You know, ever since I was a little kid, I was watching, you know, the Chicago Bulls, Michael Jordan do his thing with Scottie Pippen, Dennis Rodman, Tony Kukoc, Phil Jackson. Fell in love with the game even further when I became a Laker fan. You know, I've been a Laker fan ever since. Kobe, Shaq, Derek Fisher, Rick Ross, Rick Fox, Robert Horry, Phil Jackson once again. You know, the list goes on. Devin George, Shannon Brown, Lamar Odom, Paul Gasol, you name it, man. I was just, you know, I was just so amazed with the Lakers. The Lakers brought me and my friends and my family so many joys. You know, I was able to, I can stand here and tell you in this video, you know, I saw the Chicago Bulls win 6. I saw the Lakers win 5, you know, world peace, you know, so many wonderful things, you know, three-peat with the Lakers, then the back-to-back with the Lakers, you know, 3 times with the Bulls and another 3 times with the Bulls, you know, I was like, you know, it's been just an amazing ride for me when it comes to basketball. But now, you know, we got this new team right now on the rise. The Lakers are not doing so good, but the Warriors, you know, when I see the Warriors, I think Lakers, man. I still think Lakers, even though they're the Golden State Warriors, you know, respect to that. They're such a great team, talented roster, you know. They got Steph Curry, Klay Thompson, you got Damon Green, and now you got Kevin Durant, you know. And all these group of guys that I just mentioned, they're players that I admire. There's players that I respect because, you know, it wasn't easy. It didn't happen overnight. It took some time. And now, you know, I'm about to show you a picture from my Facebook of what happened to Kevin Durant on game five, the second quarter. Now check this out. So that's Kevin Durant right there. Hopefully you guys can see that. He went down. He injured, I believe it's his right knee. Turns out he got an MIR, and he tore his Achilles. You know, just a sad thing to happen to the player. I did write a little something because, like I said, I felt bad. You know, in tonight's game five of the NBA Finals, the Warriors won against the young and talented Toronto Raptors by 1 point. The score at the end was 106-105. Even though the Warriors got the W and won tonight's game, it was a loss for the Warriors as well as KD himself risked his body in order to give the Warriors the chance to see another day. Now, one would assume it's over for the Warriors after seeing this man go down, but it's up to his teammates to respond and play with their hearts out for Kevin Durant. Game 6 heads back to Golden State for the last time in the Orcale Arena. Because after this year, they will be playing at their new stadium in downtown in Oakland. Best of luck. May the best team win. You know, I'm about to do a separate video talking about the Toronto Raptors, but first I want to talk about the Warriors. You know, like I said, it's a sad thing to see this man go down. Such a great collective. You know, it's not like it's the end of the world. I'm pretty sure Kevin Durant, you know, still young enough. I still believe that he will return and make things right and, you know, have an opportunity to win another one. Do I think it's over? You know, tonight they're playing in Golden State in the Oracle Arena, and I feel and I believe with the crowd behind them, with the city behind them, with Kevin Durant in the shape that he's in, has, you know, given the Warriors what they need, that motivation, that inspiration, that pump to win tonight in the Oracle Arena. I really do believe that. Tonight, game 6, I'm going with the Warriors to win against Toronto and tie up the series 3-3. That's what I gotta say. That's my opinion, that's my thought. Especially after seeing this photo, man. You know, let me show you a second photo that got released a couple hours ago for today. That's Kevin Durant right now. At the hospital, he went under a surgery for the torn Achilles. He's doing better, but you could just look at his face, you know, the face that he has, you know, he's bummed out, and I wrote a little something again. Damn, I can only imagine how Kevin Durant must be feeling right now. He's probably feeling helpless and mad at himself that there's nothing he can do to help his teammates win another NBA title. Now, I've been there myself, you know. No, I didn't make it pro. No, I didn't make it to the NBA Finals. But I do know what it's like to love something, to care enough about a sport, to be passionate about a sport, to love something. And, you know, me, I always been the guy. I always been the guy when it comes to my friends, you know, especially when it came to basketball. You know, everybody else can have anything else. But when it came to basketball, me growing up as a kid, that was my sport. That was the thing that I was passionate about. That's the thing that I loved. That was my first baby. That was my first real love that I fell in love in this world from the moment I was born. You know, my mom, my dad, then came basketball, for reals. You know, not a girl, basketball was my first love. And you know, I was the type of person growing up that, you know, I took these every single game as an opportunity to get better, to want to win. I was, you know, I had that mentality, you know, I want to win, I want to be the best. No matter what it is I do, I want to be the best. And every time I lost, I'll be that kid that stands on the corner thinking, you know, man, I'll be upset because if I saw an opportunity or a chance to win, you know, I'll be like, damn, I would like take the loss hard because I was like, you know what, what could I have done? I wish I could have done something to prevent it. You know, I could have, you know, if I would have just made my shots, you know. But, you know, as I grew up and I became more mature, you know, sometimes you got to learn from the losses, you know. You know, even when you lose, it's a win for you, because when you lose, if you win everything, there's nothing to learn. And when you lose, there's, you have something to learn, you know. You got, you kind of look back, you kind of practice and try to get better and try to do something different, so when the next time comes around, you're the one with the W. So even though sometimes in this world we lose, we technically win, because maybe it's the world's way of showing us, you know what, here's something, giving us something, saying, hey, I'm giving you a life lesson right here. I'm giving you a life lesson, and there's still something to learn, young buck. And that's the way I took it. So, and the way I see it now, you know, anytime a loss, it doesn't have to be in sports. It could be anything, an acting job, a girl, you know, sometimes we don't always win. So it's okay. But anyways, I just want to like kind of express myself a little bit about the Warriors, about Kevin Durant. I definitely wish Kevin Durant the best recovery. Wish, I can't wait to see him back on the floor doing what he does. I have no doubt in my mind he's going to be back and better than ever and probably win another one. For all those doubters that think that this is it, this is the end. And as for tonight's game against Toronto in the Orcale Arena in Golden State, I'm rooting for the Warriors tonight. I really do hope they get it done and they do it for Durant. Get that W. Warriors, let's go. Hopefully you guys enjoyed my video. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Your boy Ricky Rick. This was Ricky at the Hev talking about Kevin Durant, the Warriors, Game 6. I love you guys. Until next time, check out my next video talking about the Toronto Raptors. All right?